guys. This is Deborah. Be nice to her. She's feeling miserable.
A ham sandwich, that always cheers me up.
No, thanks. I don't eat red meat.
That's all right. It's gone grey.
What are you drinking, Deborah?
I'll have a dry white wine, please.
Nothing dry in this house. Well, except the sandwich.
Gin and tonic?
Ice and lemon?
Oh, you've got ice and lemon, then?
No, but it's polite to ask, isn't it?
Les used to run a finishing school.
Now he can't even get started, can you, darling?
Oh, God. We thought you ought to come in here once, at least, Deborah.
No, I have. Can I go?
No, not until you've told us what's wrong. Been depressed for days.
I'm okay.
Is it your job?
No.
Is it money?
No.
Is it the increasingly impersonal nature of modern society?
No.
Is it the sad lack of training opportunities for our young tennis players?
If you must know, I've split up with Mike.
Oh, that's awful. That's
I found out he's sleeping around in Singapore.
Why would he do that?
Well, I don't know. Why does anybody do it? I didn't ask.
I think you've done the right thing, Deborah.
Yeah, so do I. What a bastard.
Yeah. If you want my advice, your best bet's to get your own back by sleeping with someone else yourself.
Yeah.
Someone local.
Yeah.
Tall, possibly blondish.
Or dark-haired, slightly shorter, with a winning smile.
I know what you're going through, Deborah. Dorothy and I are having an open relationship at the moment.
Is anyone else involved?
Well, Les has been giving me some advice.
No. I mean, is one of you having an affair?
Oh, nah. I think it'd be a long time before Dorothy can even look at anybody else seriously, if she ever can.
Well, if you ever feel the need to talk to anyone, you know where to find me.
Thanks.
I was talking to Deborah.
Thanks.
Don't worry. I know a few places where we can put the romance back into your life. Of course I'm not going to take advantage of her. I'm just saying that 3 months without sex, a long time for a healthy young woman. She'll need a lot of comforting while she gets her confidence back. Oh, on the rebound, yeah, yeah.
All right. Yeah? Fine, fine.
Sound a bit breathy.
Oh, do I?
Ready to play a game yet?
Just give us a chance to get over the warm-up, will you?
I think I'll start by buying Deborah some flowers. That's a weird thing, isn't it? I mean, women say they want to be taken seriously. I agree with them, 100%. And then you get them a little bunch of daffs or something, and they react like you've gone out and invented penicillin, especially for them. I think I'll buy Deborah a nice present. Nothing flashy, just enough flowers to pollinate like Surrey. Romantic meal with all the trappings. She'll shift a few hormones by the end of the evening. The trouble is, there's a couple of £100.
I've just seen Dorothy.
She's a member of this club, isn't she? Can you lend us a couple of £100?
She's with that Graham.
Well, you can't play squash on your own, can you?
Well, she could have played with Duncan. Duncan's always asking for people to play with him.
I'm not surprised. He's taken out about 5 eyes since he joined the club.
He had his hand on her shoulder.
Well, he's probably just resting it there.
Well, perhaps I should ask Dorothy. Yeah, not now, Duncan. I think we should talk.
Yes, we should.
Can I join you?
Well,
Oh, great. My bed's still warm from your body and you're
off with... Gary! A week ago, that's when I last saw you. And you were obnoxious, arrogant, and self-obsessed.
So? I suppose you think it's easy being a man in the 90s.
I don't know. Shall we ask one?
How is Graham?
Fine. No, Duncan, sorry.
I slept with him.
Duncan?
No, Graham.
I might have done.
Oh. Well, it can't have been that good if you don't remember.
Look, Gary, what about all this stuff about an open relationship?
I was talking about me.
Oh.
Look, you're not the only one who can fool around, you know. You're not the only pebble on the beach.
Right. Right. Go on, then. Go off with someone else if you want to prove something.
Right. Perhaps I will.
Hope you're a bit slicker than when you tried to pick me up.
Ha 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 ha. Hi. I'm Gary. I'm a Capricorn. Are you?
Married.
Hi. Hi. Your wife. Hi. I'm Gary. Playing squash. Great legs. Yeah. And I always get so lonely in the shower. And my hair, God, so soft and gentle. Thanks.
So, wish to borrow some money, do you, snivelling little bankrupt? Fish.
Meow.
Sorry to keep you. Just finding your details.
Looks like rain.
So, you want to borrow some money, do you?
Yes, please.
What do you intend spending it on?
Friday night.
Could you be more specific?
Well, does it really matter?
Oh, yes. I'll need some details if I'm going to lend you the bank's money.
All right. It's this woman upstairs who needs some money.
Well, in that case, I think it's best if she applies for the loan herself.
No, she doesn't know she needs it.
This all seems rather ill-conceived.
Well, I only want a few hundred. And you must have some stashed away somewhere. For a rainy day?
No,
Well, what about if I took a loan to buy a car?
Yes, that could possibly be done.
Great, well, let's do that then.
You wouldn't be planning to sell the car shortly after buying it, would you?
Yeah.
I'm afraid that's not allowed.
All right. I'm in love with this woman and I need to buy her a few things.
To quote the immortal words, money can't buy me love. Can't buy me love, oh. Money can't buy me love. Yes, well, I'm sorry.
Oh, well, never mind.
Well, goodbye. Good luck.
I think he's warmed up enough to go back in now.
Oh, waiter. There's a fly in my soup. Come to think of it, there's something pretty super in my fly as well.
Don't make things difficult, Gary. She'll be here in a minute.
Don't worry, mate. I'm going out.
Well, where are you going to go?
I thought I'd just sit in the pub and watch Les scratch his eczema.
I didn't think you'd fall apart like this just because Dorothy's seeing some other bloke.
I haven't fallen apart. I'm in a state of flux. I'm like a tightly coiled chrysalis about to burst on the world.
Well, could you do your pupating somewhere other than the draining board?
It's handy for the fridge.
Give Dorothy a ring.
I wonder what she's doing now.
Listen, there's no point in you sitting there torturing yourself with images of Dorothy bouncing up and down on something.
Thanks very much, I wasn't.
Anyway, get off that chair, I need it for the guitarist.
What guitarist?
I've got a flamenco player coming tonight, Les booked him.
What's his name?
Jeremy.
Oh, that's very Spanish.
Well, he's probably anglicised it. It's probably Jeremy.
Oh, yeah. What's his surname?
Bostock.
Smashing. Poor Deborah, she's only just split up with Mike. She'll run out screaming if you come on at her like Paul Daniels on Heat.
It's a surprise for her. She's only expecting a cup of tea and a wagon wheel.
Lend us a fiver for some beer.
No.
Oh, all right, I might just have to stay in then and do my feet.
Here's 20 quid, right? Hi.
Dermot, why?
Why what?
You're not dressed normally.
Oh, this old thing. I just take it out now and again for an airing.
Oh, hi, Gary. Aren't you staying?
Yeah, all right. Oh, I'm sorry. Have a nice evening.
Welcome.
Oh, Dermot, this isn't going to work.
Drink? I always find a gin and tonic slips down nicely this time in the evening.
Do you?
Ice and slice?
Please.
Ice a bit soft, I'm afraid.
Oh, Dermot, this is stupid. I've only just split up with Mike.
I'm just showing you what it'd be like if you went out
yes,
with me.
Yes, but it never stays like this. How long would the flowers last? A week? A month?
They'd last forever. They're plastic.
They got a meal for Mr. Lamapovi.
You're early.
It's 7:30.
You're supposed to come with a flamenco guitarist.
No, prawn fritters, special sushi.
Excuse me, since when was sushi Spanish?
No, Japanese food.
But I ordered it from a restaurant called the Hasta Mañana.
No, it's under new management. The Hasta Mañana closed down. Food poisoning. Many dead.
What did you say this was again?
Tofu stick, raw cuttlefish and horseradish.
That's a good thing about Japanese food, isn't it? You can't go wrong.
How do you know I liked it?
Intuition.
Who normally cooks? You or Gary?
Gary. He's quite adventurous sometimes. The other night he did something with peanut butter.
Saturday?
No, I think it was Friday.
You know, I do appreciate what you're doing. I mean, you could have just tried to grab me on the stairs.
Why didn't you tell me?
No, damn it, it wasn't a suggestion.
No. Oh. More sea urchin. Get ready to really relax.
A chum of mine has done up a place just like this. Would you like me to give him a ring?
No, this place has already been done, thank you.
You must be the lucky little lady I've come about.
The what?
This is Jeremy, our authentic Spanish guitar player.
Could I have a glass? Right, now, I just need to clear a bit of room on the table.
Excuse me? Isn't that an organ?
A lot of people say that.
Yeah, that's because it's an organ.
Yes, but this is really fiendish. Watch. By flicking this little toggle chappy, I can change from basic organ to piano to flamenco guitar.
That's uncanny.
It's like having an orchestra in a box, isn't it?
Not really.
Yes, well, don't mind me. You just carry on. Excuse me, would you mind? Thank you. Right, I think you're really going to like this one.
Maybe we should let him back in.
Just thinking of putting him out in the shed.
Sorry, clipped a toggle by mistake. These are flugelhorns, by the way.
They're lovely.
I think I'll send him home.
Ah, bit of a problem. Anybody got a screwdriver?
No. Have you had enough to drink?
You think I'd let you get this close if I was sober? Oh, don't spoil it, Dermot.
I'm not. This is the natural position for my arm.
Is this your idea of seduction?
Yeah. Now, when I say go, you put your tongue in my ear.
And what will you say when you want me to stop?
I don't think I said anything about stopping now, did I?
I think there's somebody at the door.
I'm looking for somebody called Debbie.
Debbie. Now, how'd you be spelling that?
Big do, is it?
Yeah. Already had to turn Sir Alistair Burnett away for not bringing a bottle.
Oh, it's you.
Oh, that Debbie.
She said she had a couple of wise guys living downstairs. Hello, Deb.
Dermot, this is Mike.
I think we should go up to your flat and talk.
We've already talked.
What are all these flowers for?
Well, Dermot's been trying to get my mind off of what you've been getting up to.
Do you want to make something of it?
All right, so I've been a bad boy, but I'm back now. Surely we can talk about this.
Not now, Bill.
Right. Time for a bit of a break, eh?
Oh, look, Mike, I don't trust you.
Any more of that wine?
Will somebody get him out of here?
Listen, pal, I think it's you she wants to leave, all right? I mean, I'm only guessing.
All right, you two, pull your pants up. There you go.
Oh, for God's sake.
Who's this?
Gary, this is Mike.
Mike? Well, you're Mike. Naughty Mike. You've been working abroad, haven't you? Or should I say several broads?
Mike, don't!
You all right, mate? I've had a bit of a row with my bird, so I know what you're going through.
Yeah, well.
You're going through women like there's no tomorrow. Do you want a quiz?
So, what happened after he nutted you?
Well, somebody said any chance of a fill-up. I think that was Jeremy. Then I was sick on Deborah's shoes. Then Deborah threw Mike out, and I was sick on her shoes again.
Poor old thing. It sounded so pathetic on the phone. Hope you weren't putting it on.
No, I am genuinely pathetic.
True.
Thanks for coming. Does Graham mind?
Actually, I'm not seeing him anymore.
Oh, well, he was a dull little git, wasn't he?
Well, we didn't have a lot in common. It's hard to spend a candlelit evening with someone whose two main topics of conversation are barge holidays and bowel disorders. And his taste in music.
Put a record on.
Yeah? What do you fancy? Mm. Barry White.
Mm.
Yeah. Hello, Dermot. I've been hearing about your romantic evening.
Yeah, it went all right. Except for the food, the drink, the organist, the violence and the vomiting.
Gary? Where's your hi-fi?
Eh?
I'm afraid I had to pawn it to pay for last night.
You what?
Sorry. Never mind, though. I made alternative arrangements for entertainment for the next few days. These are flugelhorns, by the way.